Praxis Prepper.
Mimi!
Hey everybody, this is Praxis. For the past several months, the whole world's been in it together with the coronavirus pandemic, and I think a lot of people have learned a lot about preparedness and the value of being prepared for things. Specifically people who weren't going into this. Things like N95 masks, respirators, cleaning supplies, toilet paper became a hot commodity for a while. And I think going into what is probably going to be the 2021 season, with going into the fall here in the Northern Hemisphere, I think it's reasonable to think that there's going to be an increase in infections, and we're going to be seeing a lot of the issues that we saw early in the pandemic kind of returning as we kind of ramp up and start seeing more cases, flowing through our communities. And it's important to think not just of the shortages that you noticed at the beginning, you know, things like if you didn't have respirators, if you didn't have cleaning supplies, those might be things that were, thrust upon you early on. But it's important to think about other things as well. I'm going to give you an example. What's behind me right here are the solar hot water panels for the house, for the new house that I'm building that I'm not able to live at yet. Right now I'm at a temporary house, and at that temporary house we have an oil burner that creates the domestic hot water for the house, and it has been broken since pretty much the beginning of the pandemic. We haven't been able to take hot showers, washing dishes has all been with cold water, and we've been able to make that be pretty much okay without having to have anyone come in and fix it. Now you might wonder, well, why didn't I just have somebody come in and fix it? People have been available, but there are two reasons really. I didn't want to have people coming into the house because they would be a possible vector for disease. They're touching everything all over the place. But in addition to that, and probably even the bigger reason, is that in my specific situation, the oil burner that heats the domestic hot water for the house is right smack dab next to my extensive pantry and prepping supply, storage area. I'm not going to move the entire thing, and I didn't really feel comfortable having somebody come into my home, ahead of what might be shortages, and looking around the home and think to themselves, wow, it's like a grocery store down here. There's everything that anyone could need if there was ever an emergency situation. I felt a little bit uncomfortable with that, so we just haven't had anyone come in, and we've been fine with that because we've had our preps. So if there are any kind of indirect sorts of situations that you can picture arising for yourself in the fall that aren't necessarily N95 masks or cleaning supplies or toilet paper, I mean, cover those bases, because we all know that those were issues for a lot of people early on. But once you have those covered, think about secondary issues. If something breaks in your home, do you have the tools or the knowledge to fix it yourself? And if you don't, do you have workarounds for it? So now is the time to do it. Things aren't so terrible right now. I know for some people they feel terrible, and there's lots of terrible things going on all over the place, but it can get much worse. It's probably going to get worse, and now is the time to fix things ahead of that time. That's it. Thanks for watching.
This episode has been brought to you in part by Prescott Caliber Club and Jesky Defense Strategies. Prescott Caliber Club is a federally licensed firearm manufacturer and retail store specializing in firearms, survival gear, and producing great online content. If you want to thank them for supporting this channel, go check them out at prescottcalclub.com.